the only national team in history to win 3 consecutive major international titles, and the first to win back-to-back European Championship titles, as well as co-holding the record for the longest unbeaten international run in history, the 2008-2012 Spanish team has a serious case to be one of, if not the most dominant international dynasty in football history. What's going on, guys? It's Raymar back again for another video, and today we're gonna make a case for the 2008-2012 Spanish team being the most dominant international dynasty in football history. But before we start, I just want to let you guys know that I will be giving away a brand new Adidas Jabulani ball, so make sure you watch till the end to learn more about it. So with that being said, let's get on to it. As all great teams are made of individuals as well as collectives, we're gonna look at the set of players that would build and become the very core of this iconic Spanish national side. Without them, this historic Spanish squad would have never happened. We'll start by going through the important players that were there for all 3 of the major tournament wins in 2008, 2010, and 2012. Firstly, at goal, we have the legendary Iker Casillas. For as long as I can remember, Casillas has stood at the helm as Spain's goalkeeper and captain, someone who's in the argument for the greatest goalkeeper of all time and Spain's most capped player. Iker Casillas has made a name for himself as one of the top goalkeepers of his generation, playing with Real Madrid. Serving as the country's captain from 2008 to 2016, Casillas holds the record for most UEFA Team of the Year appearances by a goalkeeper with 6, and also holds the record for most FIFA World 11 appearances, dozens of trophies, so he definitely has the experience in the squad's most important position. On a side note, I've seen quite a few of you guys asking me to make a video about him and other goalkeepers too, just because they need more respect. But we'll save that for another time. Next, we have the midfield god himself, Xavi. Honestly, there isn't too much to be said about him, we all know just how great he is. Xavi plays an amazing midfielder that, believe it or not, would sometimes come off the bench due to the sheer amount of talent on the Spanish squad with Cesc Fabregas, a fellow recipient of the Golden Boy Award, which has previously been won by the likes of Lionel Messi and Wayne Rooney. Fabregas' talents have been recognized at a young age since he was at Arsenal, where he broke several club records. Just like many of his fellow Spanish squad seniors, Fabregas was an exceptional passer and a playmaker. He had some of the best free kick taking skills and long ball passing on the counterattack. Although he wasn't much of a goal scoring focused player, it was his vision and ball control that made him such a threat, always making the right pass at the right time. In fact, he was the one who assisted Andres Iniesta in that last minute goal against Netherlands in the World Cup final. Fabregas is also Spain's all-time leading assist leader, having more than even Xavi and Iniesta with less matches played. At defensive midfielder, we have one of the more unrecognized legends in Xabi Alonso. Although he wasn't particularly very athletic or flashy, his ability to pass and maintain possession was absolutely vital for Spain's success. The one area in which his passing really stood out was his long-range accuracy. Also, one of the most accurate free kick and penalty takers in the entire squad, which shows you his composure, which is a great thing for a holding midfielder to have. Just by watching him play, you can tell he's never panicking even when teams try to close out on him, which, considering Spain's relatively slow-paced midfield, was absolutely necessary. If you need any more proof, former teammate and Liverpool legend Steven Gerrard called Xabi Alonso the best midfielder he has ever played with. While coach Pep Guardiola has admitted Alonso is one of the best midfielders he has ever seen. The last midfielder who was there for all 3 titles is no other than David Silva. The current captain of Manchester City is of their dynasty, just because their midfield was so incredibly stacked that putting him on the bench would just be a waste of his talent. Already considered a Manchester City legend, David Silva is also Spain's 4th highest goal scorer and 2nd all-time assist leader behind only Cesc Fabregas, also outdoing Xavi and Iniesta with less matches played. His most notable skills are maintaining possession, ball control, and amazing touch and dribble. David Silva's ability to read the game and control the tempo has earned him the nickname Merlin by Manchester City fans because of his wizardry on the pitch. On the defensive end, we have one of the toughest and best center of all 3 championship squads was no other than Fernando Torres. Now, I've already gone into a lot more detail about how good Fernando Torres was in a previous video, but we're just gonna run into a quick summary here. Torres is Spain's third highest goal scorer with over 100 caps for his country. A Liverpool legend and an absolute goal scoring machine back in his prime, Torres placed third in the 2008 Ballon d'Or voting behind Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi. That alone should speak volumes of his talent. This Spanish squad had three top three Ballon d'Or caliber players from 2008 to 2012, which is absolutely ridiculous. He was named the Euro 2008 final man of the match, won the Euro 2012 Golden Boot, the Confederations Cup Golden Boot, two FIFA World 11 appearances, two Premier League Team of the Year appearances, and one UEFA Team of the Year appearance. Was that crazy long hair of his. Jokes aside, his defensive positioning and wisdom helped guide the younger guys on the Spanish defense like Piqué and Ramos. It was Puyol who scored that vital last-minute goal off a corner kick header against Germany in the 20th bench because Spain had too many world-class midfielders in Juan Mata. Premier League fans, especially those who watch Chelsea, will know that Mata has great vision, control, and passing to just be an amazing playmaker. He helped Chelsea win the Champions League and FA Cup, and was their multiple-time Player of the Year. He also spearheaded the U19 and U21 Spanish squads to an international title while winning the Golden Player Award before moving up to the men's team. Mata was there for the 2010 World Cup and the 2012 Euros. Up next, we have Pedro, another longtime Barcelona midfielder who played through their consistently dominant dynasty from 2008 to 2015. Don't forget that Pedro was a crew, but also his consistency. Now, you might be thinking that overall, Spain was a fairly slow team. Well, thanks to Jesus Navas, they could always switch it up on the wing. Anyone who's ever played FIFA Ultimate Team, or just even knows a little bit about Navas, would know that he is fast as hell. I'm sure Manchester City fans need no introduction to the man, as he holds the record for the most competitive appearances. He's also been awarded La Liga's Best Attacking Midfielder in the 2009-2010 season. Navas was vital for the 2010 World Cup and the 2012 Euro, as he was the go-to guy to switch up Spain's slow-paced tiki-taka play to a more offensively aggressive style. And last but not least, my personal favorite player on the Spanish team, David Villa. I've even made a video on just how underrated his legendary career was. In the 2008 Euro, Villa mentioned his club career goal-scoring ratio is .50 throughout his nearly 20-year career, which just gives you an idea of his talent and consistency. Not to mention, he even broke his leg around his prime years too. But if you want to know more about him, link to my David Villa video will be on the top. Santi Cazorla, Juan Capdevila, Raul Albiol, and Jordi Alba. Now let's begin with how Spain would win each tournament. In 2008, Spain's immensely gifted players had such great passing and possession ability that they were able to pioneer the infamous tiki-taka style of play. Barcelona, at the height of their glory, employed this style of play mainly due to the midfield geniuses in Xavi and Andres Iniesta, but when you added all those other Spanish talents outside Barcelona, Spain had without a doubt in my mind the greatest midfield ever. The entire world was trying to figure out how to stop Spain's overwhelming possession game, and likewise, many top clubs were also trying to do the same with Barcelona. In the 2008 Euros, Spain completely dominated their group of Greece, Sweden, and Russia. In the quarterfinal, they just narrowly beat Italy 4-2 on penalties, but like I mentioned, Spain had many great penalty kick takers throughout their entire team, so they were at the advantage. In the semi-final, they beat Russia 3-0 with relative ease. And in the final against Germany, it was Fernando Torres who scored the only goal in the match to get his country's first European title in over 50 years. Of the 23 players selected in the 2008 Euro team of the tournament, Spain had 9 players in it. In the 2010 World Cup, Spain would once again come out on top of their group, which consisted of Chile, Switzerland, and Honduras. During this entire tournament, Spain would lose only once, and that was to Switzerland. Now, you might think that they had an easy group, but the real competition came in the knockout stages. Their first opponent was Portugal, which they narrowly won 1-0 in a close game thanks to David Villa. In the quarterfinal, it would be David Villa once again putting on a show against Paraguay with another 1-0 win. They would face off longtime rival Germany in the semi-final, and I gotta tell you, this was such a close match. It was thanks to a late header by Carles Puyol that Spain managed to survive through this Germany team. And finally, against a stacked Netherlands team in the World Cup final, it was Andres Iniesta in the 116th minute who was finally able to score a goal and secure Spain's first ever World Cup win. Finally, in the 2012 Euros, Spain had once again went undefeated in their group, which had Italy, Croatia, and the Republic of Ireland. Spain would defeat France in the quarterfinal with a 2-0 win, with both goals being scored by veteran Xabi Alonso. In the semi-final, they would meet Portugal and Ronaldo, in which they would end up winning through penalties. And like I've already mentioned before, a lot of Spain's players were very good penalty kick takers, so they were at the advantage. Not to mention they had the better goalkeeper in Iker Casillas. And lastly, they would absolutely demolish Italy in the final with a 4-0 win, making them the only national team in history to win 3 consecutive major international titles and the first to win back-to-back European Championship titles. But yeah, that's pretty much all I have for you guys today. Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Do you think they're the greatest international dynasty, or can you name a team even better? By the way, I will be giving away the official ball of the 2010 World Cup, the Adidas Jabulani, which is an incredibly iconic ball and one I personally like using when I play. All you have to do is like this video, leave a comment, and be subscribed to win. Make sure you do all 3 because I will check and I'll announce the winner at the end of the month. As always, if you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like as it really helps support my channel and allows me to continue making these documentaries for you guys. And if you're new and want to see more videos like this, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on anything. Also, you can check my channel to see all the other football documentaries if you want to see more. Once again, thank you for all the love and support. You guys are the best, and I honestly mean it. So I hope you all take it easy, and I'll see you in the next one.